Alvin El Chico, ABS-CBN News.
Joining us live in the studio to talk about the lifting of Executive Order 839 is Mr. Ernst Wanten. He is President and Managing Director for Total Philippines. Sir, good evening. Thank you for joining us.
Good evening, Ricky.
Let me clarify this. The estimate is that once the price controls are lifted, you'll see an average of 5 pesos a liter increase in the price of in the retail price of fuel. For Total, is that the same amount that we're expecting?
Anyhow, that's the loss that we're having at the moment to liter, so that's the minimum that normally we should get back.
So yes. The minimum, it could actually be more.
We'll see, because in the end it's all linked to international oil prices and they are volatile, they move.
But assuming that all things remain equal, then you're looking at about 5,
yeah.
Right? Is that correct?
Yeah.
And you've agreed, as well as the other retailers, have agreed to stagger the increase?
Yes, but they've asked us gently to do it in a staggered way.
Did they tell you how much to stagger it by, or are they leaving it up to your discretion?
But they leave it, as far as I know, because it can always change, they leave it up to our discretion. It's also, we are not allowed to talk with the other colleagues, let's call it like that, other oil companies to say, how are we going to do it, because this is cartelization. That's not allowed.
Mm-hmm. So we're going to see what the other guys do first, and then I suppose in this, given the market structure...
This is a free market, so it moves.
Apparently,
and
supposedly.
Yeah, believe me, this is...
Okay, so we'll see what the big players do, and chances are the smaller players will follow suit. All right. Well, it's been lifted, and I know that the industry and the business community have been asking that it be lifted for quite a while.
Yeah.
Does it at least satisfy your company that problems like this will now sort of go away?
Of course, now at the moment we're at least happy that this EO is being replaced with, I would say, measures that should have been taken from the start, and I think which will be much more effective. But still there remains the worry that, okay, this is now gone, but it's like a sort of Damocles hanging over our head for whatever reason, or it could always be reinvoked again in the future, which is, frankly said, not acceptable.
And they've said that they reserve the right to reimpose price controls if they don't like the way that you're increasing prices.
I've heard, yeah.
Does that sort of disagree with your understanding of a deregulated market?
It's totally disagrees with our concept of a deregulated market.
But
absolutely.
Yeah, let me just go into that, because you know you were seeing some of the customers lining up for fuel today. It's a natural, rational, economic reaction. But you hear people asking them, and they say, well, you know, some people believe that fuel companies like yourselves are actually hoarding it, and this is artificially done. You've heard that, I'm sure. How can you assure the public that you're really just reacting to market movements and not, in fact, hoarding or speculating on the price?
Yeah, but first of all, of course, hoarding is normally artificially slowing down your supply in order to increase your prices, which of course here is it's impossible. It's that you can't do. That's first of all. But and secondly, of course, we're just there, and we are there to supply the market. But in the end, you're a company. You have to have decent results. Let's call it like that. And for that, you have to make a margin. And the last couple of weeks, we were simply every liter you were selling was straight loss. So.
What are the options for Total now? I mean, you're going to be able to get you're going to be able to get those losses back, I suppose. There's an understanding that you will be able to recover the losses.
That's a very nice expression, to recover the losses. Now, as I said, this is an open market. This is a reactive market, and the market mechanism plays. So you'll have competition, people making prices and adapting. So I don't see really, to be honest, the recovering of that loss, how that should take place.
Do you then have a problem looking forward into next year with the regulation environment with regard to your industry now? I mean, they deregulated it, but the government is saying that this is an extraordinary situation. We've got a problem with the storms, and therefore they've invoked their power to impose price controls, and they've reserved, as you said, the right to do that at any time in the future. What does this do to your outlook?
But it adds, I would say, again, an extra factor to the uncertainty of operating this country. And as being a fairly new player, we've been now 12 years in this country, where we try to build up some competition to the big three, I can just say it's extremely difficult to do this. And I think in general, if you see, of course, the investment climate in the Philippines as receiving one of the lowest foreign interest rates, it's just adding to that uncertainty. Mm-hmm. And I always say, if you want to invest, in the end, there are two rules for that. One, you want an acceptable return. And secondly, you want a stable environment, or anyhow, to be sure to measure your risk. And measures like this, like the EO and so on, don't help.
Do you think that your sentiments are shared by other people in the industry?
Yeah, absolutely. No, yeah. I've been able in the last couple of weeks, and it's in the industry, but it's not only in specifically the oil industry, but in general, if you talk with other business people, the way that the people went about this and so on creates another very uncertain investment plan.
Petron said that they were expected to lose about 1.5 billion pesos in the fourth quarter if the EO stayed in place. Would you be able to give us some rough numbers as to how this would have impacted Total in the Philippines?
Total, let's say unluckily, we were relatively more hit than the other oil companies because all our service stations are in Luzon. Mm-hmm. So that was already, let's say, which aggravated everything. We were losing easily 2 to 3 million pesos a day. So you can make the calculation. Okay, we're a smaller player than Petron, but a figure that they mentioned didn't surprise me.
Mm-hmm. Okay, moving forward, did you have plans to expand your network here, your retail outlets and your wholesale business? Was there a plan to expand that?
We started 12 years ago, and we are continuously expanding. Mm. We've invested now a bit more than 4 billion pesos in this country. But if I tell you that cumulated after 12 years of activity, we've lost 2 billion pesos, mm-hmm. I can say two things on that one. We're here for the long term, and you invest. But at a certain moment, of course, that patience runs out. So that's a risk. But nevertheless, I can only say, the big bosses of Asia are coming next week, just to give you an impression that it's not taken lightly what is happening, and we'll see what we do next year.
Is a pull out of the Philippines a possibility? Is it in the universe of possibilities?
That's an extreme scenario. I would say we're not there at all. Mm-hmm. We still believe in the Philippines. I've got an excellent team working for me. We got good business partners, so we'll try to work further. But it's not easy.
And what do you think could happen to make these concerns go away? I mean, granted, what's done is done. They're saying they're lifting the oil price controls. But what would the industry like to see moving forward to prevent, to ease the concerns?
For us, the deregulated environment we are having is fine. There is one, and I would even say the most fundamental problem for the oil industry, and I haven't mentioned it yet, is the oil smuggling, mm-hmm. which takes away completely the level playing field, and that is really the problem. So from a long term, for legitimate players like us to be here and to stay here and to be able to earn at least some money, that is another problem that should be solved.
All right, Mr. Wanten, we're going to